fight for every single one.
Because the drill press really isn't doing the job? Or?
No, it's... not... oh, a little bit, but... they're pretty precise, so they...
What would be a better way to get this job done? Is something you'd send away, or?
I don't know.
Thank you. Hang on. Hold on to get much.
seconds right now.
But what do you need to do differently?
I'm gonna cut. See, it's.
So the chef cut was 1.5 minutes?
Yeah. Just get the measurement here.
You want to do this by yourself, or are you going to?
Yeah.
Give it a go.
That's a bit much nicer.
To say the least.
Did you jack that one out too, or was that one already fine?
That one was already nice. I can't push it uphill.
Can you do that again? Thank you.
because so, you gotta, this thing doesn't fit through the hole. Mm-hmm. So you gotta do it from both sides on a table. This is tacked, now this is tacked. Once it's tacked, you put it in place, and this slips right on. It was pretty nice alignment with everything. Just check that the shaft is parallel. It's great with the CNC cut. And that basically slid right in, and then, and this just slid right in as well. I just ground the key down just a little slide up, just a little bevel on the other side, so it goes in perfectly. Had no problem getting it in. That's good alignment throughout. It's actually, it's pretty good. If that procedure is followed, I think it probably takes like, I would estimate, now that we know exactly how to do it, half an hour to get to this structure before to welding, then tack it, and then put this thing on. This is probably another half hour to put this on, and then weld for about an hour. It's not a lot of welding, but it's hard to get into the welds. You don't have to take anything off, but it's hard to get into those welds, so you gotta go from all angles. And the shafts should still spin. Like right now, we should be able to spin the shaft. Yeah, so that's good. That's all fine. It didn't get. I was checking the shaft throughout to make sure it didn't spin. Yep.
All right, we can test whether a longer bolt will work, because that's essentially.
I could test it. I got this conference thing. I'm gonna show the work, so.
That slid right on, Lucky.
Yeah?
Just.
Oh, yeah, so you just do it, yeah.
One side than the other.
Yeah, I see. That's good. Got the motor, but. 1/4 inches. From here. Yep, so it's exactly 11 1/4. And that way gets you in there, gets you the first specific distance, so that's exactly 1.75 going into. So key ends like right there. As far as the double chain cutter, have to worry about that, I think. Get a couple of these wheels on.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be back here. This came out okay. Like when, what I did here was I used the spacer.
Yeah.
It actually works out nice, because now you can, it's actually good. You can get it in, and here you have to kind of work it to get it in. It's pretty good. It didn't, like this, that strategy is working really well with the holes, because it didn't bind down, it stayed pretty even, because when you get it, the weld like right in there, it doesn't make it pinch. So that's actually quite good. It's relatively
just,
straightforward.
I think
we messed up on this.
What's that?
This should have been on the other side. This thing should be flipped 180 degrees. I didn't notice that. So I ground the edge there to get a weld in there. But yeah, that edge should have been in there. Then better. That needs to be ground down. You know.
Who messed up I did when I drew this? Or
No, you actually did it okay. Thing is, we got to flip it 180, and therefore that space is going to be right under that other plate that goes on the other side. I didn't notice we had that level of detail. I actually forgot we put that in there. But that actually, I think, works quite well. So that's good. And it's got that lip on this side, so the thing sits off of that. Yeah. On the other side, it doesn't have it. I thought it was an error, but it's actually not because it's sitting on the other piece there, right?
Exactly.
These holes line up really well. That's good. So we can have these to stabilize it. You can probably do these two, and then maybe like put one or two. However you want to attach it.
Yeah, when you have me design this, you asked for either 16th or 8th. Like parallel, not hanging out like that.
Yeah, that's good. And I got to span the whole length, so we just got key material.
I guess the key measurement is the distance from here to where it's gonna, because these are all gonna butt up just in the same position on the entire one knot. So the key distance is here to wherever I'm measuring.
Right. And the dimensions here are such that the shaft.
These drilled out nuts then will be welded to the.
Yeah, welded to the collar.
Yeah.
Solid weld.
Yep.
Yeah, these are all like plus minus 1/4 inch. Yeah. So yeah, we're pretty good on the shaft lens. These are all exactly 1 3/4. So the keys are going to be 1.75. These ones are too short. It's like
French. No, no, it doesn't really look like it matters much, does it?
No.
Yeah. So we just do like that. So four of them. So that'll be the thing to do. Now, it's probably once you find out the exact location, just take that up and probably probably it's the easiest.
Well, you can't, it has to be centered. See how it's resting here? There's a little gap here.
Okay. Yeah. So we gotta at least tack it in place. Mm-hmm.
Are all these holes the same?
They're 6 inches, they should be, but you want to use the corresponding marked shaft.
Okay. In other words, some of them.
Some of them might
be welded here, some of them might be welded here, some of them might be welded here.
Yeah, these are all 8 inches, and on these holes is plus minus a quarter inch. And the distance between the two holes is exactly to like 1/20th of an inch because I did it on the mill.
Okay.
So this should be actually, if you do one, you could probably be rather safe to do, but I mean, there's about a half an inch difference on the shafts maybe.
Mm-hmm.
A quarter, probably like a quarter inch difference on the shafts.
Well, that's one reason we're giving ourselves the 2 inches.
2.5 inches should be
2.5 inches.
Plenty. Right there. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and the shafts, and they're pretty